All right. I'm trying to maybe get the camera. Crap. Well, so I'm going to be playing this. All right. So basically what this game is, what the heck? What just happened? Huh? Okay, no idea what happened. Guessing it was glitch. God. Okay. Well, that was a helpful glitch. Huh? Let's kind of do this. Oh, that's crap.
Put this James credit for even trying to do it. But it's a big reason why we lost, and in the end, it kind of put us back a little bit.
Jacob, you were the first person to go to Ghost Island. Did people ask you, what's it like, what's it about?
I think I was trying to get the inspiration out. I pretty much sold everything. I even told them about my opportunity of getting an advantage.
What did he share regarding this opportunity or advantage he talked about?
Yeah, so he showed us that he found a hidden meaning in the idol, so that surprised us.
Jay, the other question is, you really have no idea what Ghost Island is about.
Yeah, there definitely is some kind of like information imbalance. I mean, Jacob has actually been there and spent the night on the island, and we have it, but he's one of our own, and Justin is
great. Great phrase, information imbalance, because that really is where survival often tips, is the information imbalance. So, Jacob, when you rejoined the tribe, did you feel welcome?
I felt welcome to a surprising degree. I expected a million material, and it says a lot about my relationship with this tribe, and it makes me feel more comfortable with the code.
So let me ask you, Harry, you still feel you're the greatest tribe?
Absolutely. I still believe 100% these are some of the best people that have ever been on Survivor.
Stephanie, where do you sit on this idea that Jacob has, which is basically glass half full?
You know, Jeff, in my life, I'm a glass half full type of person as well. So I understand where he's coming from. I think that that's just who he is as a person.
Jacob, is that really the way you are?
No. I'm an erotic, paranoid, indoor kid. Maybe when I come out with that kind of bravado, it's so I can feel like I'm not going to just die on the spot. I have a dream about getting to the end of this game, and to do that, I have to fight all the fears that come with it.
Jenin, where's the tribe right now in terms of alliances?
This is our second tribal. I think there's a little bit more thought and alliances and some of that. We're kind of moving around a little bit. So in the front here, I think we'll be a little different.
Jacob, you're shaking your head at that. You agree with that?
Yeah, this game is becoming way more about relationships, way more about keeping your trust, way more about loyalty.
So is there any concern, even though you've had a warm welcome, that you might be out of a group?
Absolutely. For all I know, you know, when I wasn't there, they all gathered up and said, okay, make me feel good, and I'll get rid of the next time. I don't know if that happened. I hope it didn't happen. I don't think it happened. It could happen. And, you know, any kind of work that I've put in the past couple days to help myself and help my allies and my friends, it might all be in vain.
Michael, how about for you? What are you seeing in terms of relationships forming and growing? Because that becomes a big part of the vote.
Right, yeah, it's a huge part of it, and last vote was pretty unanimous, but two losses back to back, we gotta start doing something different because we don't want to keep this bad momentum going.
So, Brendan, do you take some measure of comfort that you're okay, because they need your strength?
No, I don't. I don't think this is all about physical strength at this point. I think those days are over in Survivor, so yeah, I feel a little bit worried.
Michael, does that concern you? Because you're clearly a physically fit guy.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, hearing Brendan say that, I just sure hope that's not the case. But I'm just going to align so that.
Okay. Yeah. Hopefully, you like this.
I'm still gonna do this live stream still. Hopefully they can subscribe me. I'll be still continuing on doing this. So yeah. Here we go.
Thank you.
I just want to get to a shout out to Annie. Annie Trost. Please subscribe to her. She's really cool. She's my girlfriend, so hopefully you can do that. I'm just gonna try to at least hopefully I won't die. There we go.
Go away.
Stay tuned for scenes from our next episode. Oh, look, another antimicrobial queen. You know how to make anything happen. You can gain a rapid recall of bad wax in just 1 week, but the fastest retinol formula available is clinically proven to work on fine lines and wrinkles. In 1 week, that definitely works.
The heck? Okay.
I can help you.
Oh my gosh. Yes. Sorry about that, guys.
Thank you. I say, but time to share with you. You post circle, it's not walls. It's hidden. And it has, and it says, I don't know if it's that, it says it has probiotics in it. Very little. Time to get off front.
Oh, shoot.
To get off it.
Kenny, would you be quiet? God. Guys, screw it. Please subscribe me, and I'll see you next live stream.